Leader of the opposition, Dr. Gale Rigobert, lamented what she referred to as the expansion in government. Dr. Rigobert says over the past 3 years, there has been an increase in the number of mayors and consultants, etc. To compound matters, the current economic status of the country, she says, is making life difficult for taxpayers, and an increase on the number of constituencies will increase the financial burden on their backs. Dr. Rigobert took issue with a statement in the House on Tuesday by Prime Minister and Minister for Finance, Dr. Kenny Anthony. According to her, Dr. Anthony indicated that the change will increase the wage bill by only 0.66%. Dr. Rigobert says this is beside the point. For her, the real issue is that this is 0.66% too much.
But as I indicated in the House yesterday, to indicate that it's a mere 0.66% or only 0.66%, it is a 0.66% of the wage bill that the country simply cannot afford at this time. And let us not forget that at last year's budget, the government made a proposal of a 5% wage cut for civil servants. So how do you now juxtapose a 0.66% potential increase in salaries if we move from 17 to 21 seats, and having only under a year ago asked or proposed a 5% wage cut?
According to Dr. Rigobert, government has made it clear that it plans to adhere to the recommendations made by the Constituency Boundaries Commission report, but noted that it will come with a cost of over $357,000 to add 4 new constituencies. Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony earlier in his speech told the House of Assembly yesterday that there will be financial implications based on the recommendations made from the report. The credibility of that report has been called into question. Dr. Rigobert was disappointed with the government's response. She felt that Dr. Anthony ought to have explained to the House what fiscal measures would be put in place to sustain the cost of increasing the boundaries.
And that a discussion that I would have liked to have heard yesterday is, one, a recognition that given the economic contraction of the last 3 years, and given what are the obvious cost implications for the increase from 17 to 21 seats, that the government would have presented to the House creative fiscal measures to raise the necessary finance to meet that cost. Because inevitably, it is taxpayers who will bear the burden of the additional 4 seats.
Parliamentarians have been divided on the issue of increasing the constituencies, with some for and some against. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.